new job, new check, and new money plans. Let's talk about the racks that I'm about to be making and how that impacts my plans for my money and my financial journey. Let's get into it. Hi, I'm Shannon of The Wealth Vibe, and I create videos to help you eliminate debt, grow your income, and build wealth. I have finally accepted a job offer, and if you haven't heard it yet, check out this video right here because I show you the exact moment when I got an offer from this new job that I will be starting on April 20th. And this new income is going to change my financial trajectory, and it has huge impacts for my ability to be able to build wealth. And I'm going to talk to you about what impact that's going to have in this video. And drop down in the comment section and leave a money bag emoji so that I know that you're here and I can say hi to you. So let's get into the details about how this job is going to change my ability to build wealth. Since the beginning of this channel, I have been very open with you about the income that I've made and how I have been using that income to be able to pay off $60,000 worth of debt and to help build me to a positive net worth. And I have really debated long and hard about how much details I want to share about my new compensation package, because it's a package and it's actually something that I've never really encountered before. And I think it is a little too complicated in some respects because it is a compensation plan that is built out over 4 years. And so it's kind of a little, I think, unnecessary information to provide on this channel in that detail because it's going to be confusing. And I also don't know in the end what my total compensation will actually be because there are so many moving pieces to this compensation package. But I will say that for this first year, the majority of my salary, about 95% of my salary, is composed of base salary and sign-on bonus. And so I have a huge sign-on bonus. My sign-on bonus is actually exactly 50% of my salary. And so that puts my salary into the multiple six-figure range. And so I will be making a lot of money, more money than I ever imagined being able to make from a 9-to-5 job, having a public health degree. And yeah, it's just mind-blowing, okay? So yes, this is like going to have a major impact on my finances. But I have a few things that I want to accomplish with this money, and I'm going to be able to accomplish a whole lot faster. So let's break down where my starting point is. If you've been watching my channel, you know that I started with $108,000 of debt, and you can learn more about the different types of debt I had, the story behind the debt, and everything in this video right here. But yeah, I had $108,000 of debt, and I paid off about $60,000 of that debt, close to, and now all I have is my student loan debt. And my student loan debt is about $53,000 right now. And so that's the only debt that I have, and I've been able to move my net worth from negative, I don't know, 50,000 something, or actually, maybe even higher than that. I don't remember how high it was because I think the first time I actually calculated my net worth, I had already paid off several of my debt accounts. So I think the first recorded time that I calculated my net worth, which is in this video right here, it was around the negative $50,000 range. And the last time I calculated my net worth, it had increased by 40-something%. I'm still in the negative, but I'm close to being positive. Let's break it all down. So there are six things that I want to accomplish with the new income that I'll receive. The first is maxing out my 401k. So if you want to learn more about 401ks, you can check out this video right here. But essentially it's a employer-sponsored retirement account. And typically for 2020, the income limits for an individual is $19,500. So in order to max out a 401k within the year of 2020, a person would have to contribute about $1,600 every single month over 12 months to be able to max that out and reach the $19,500 limit. And so that is my plan, is to contribute about $1,600 every single month to my 401k. Now, because I'll be starting this in April, I actually won't be able to max out my 401k. So I can't really say that I can't do it, because I could increase that contribution, but based off of the plan of, you know, contributing $1,600 every single month, I will be short a few thousand dollars. And who knows, maybe at the end of the year, I might decide to increase my contribution so that way I'm able to max out completely. So the reason why this is important for me is, one, I don't really have any retirement account savings, especially when they're employer-based, because the only one that I did have, I rolled over it to a traditional IRA, and that's something that you can do when you leave one job and go to the next one, but it's just a couple hundred dollars. And the other reason why this is important is because the tax bracket that I will be in is actually more advantageous for me to put money into a 401k, so that way I can pay less in taxes every single year. So that's the plan with the 401k, and this is really going to set me off in a really great trajectory, especially now that the stock market is down a little bit from its highest high in 2020, and it's down a little bit now. So I'll be getting kind of like a discount on everything that I put into my 401k now. The second thing that I want to accomplish with this new income is to max out my HSA. If you want to learn more about HSAs, you can check out this video right here. But essentially, an HSA is a health savings account that's provided to you if you have a high deductible insurance plan and your employer offers this type of plan. And so I'll be able to contribute to an HSA. And for 2020, the contribution limits for an individual is $3,500. So in order to max that out, I would have to contribute $290 or so every single month. But in order to actually max it out, I would need to actually raise my contributions a little bit so I can actually meet the limit by the end of 2020. But right now, I'm just gonna keep the amount that I would have to typically contribute if I were doing a 12-month type of, you know, payment situation for my HSA. And this is also really valuable because it'll be able to reduce my taxable income, so I pay less on taxes. And then second, it's another way that I can be able to invest money and save money for retirement, but just for medical expenses in this case. Now, the third thing that I want to do also relates to retirement accounts. And if you want to learn more about this type of retirement account called an individual retirement account, an IRA, you can check out this video right here. And so with this type of account, what I want to do with this is actually max it out for 2 years. I want to max it out for 2019 and 2020. So you may have learned that, you know, due to the pandemic, they decided to push back the tax payment deadlines or tax, you know, filing deadline. So typically that's in April, on April 15th, and now it's in July, on July 15th. And so what that also did is it pushed back the time where people can actually contribute to some of their retirement accounts, such as the IRA. So you can still make contributions into your IRA for 2019, as long as you max it out by, or not, you don't even have to max it out, but as long as you make contributions to the 2019 IRA by July 15, 2020. So up until this point, I only have $3,000 in my IRA from 2019. So in order to max it out, I need to contribute an additional $3,000 into my 2019 IRA. And then I need to also contribute $6,000 to my 2020 IRA to be able to max that out. So we're talking about a few thousand dollars every single month so that I'm able to max out both of these accounts. Okay, so now this other one, this other goal that I have, it's not really a goal. It's just I gotta pay some money to the IRS. And so you probably know that I have owed lots of money to the IRS in the past. Pretty much every single year, I have owed thousands of dollars to the IRS for taxes because I've either had self-employment income or I had income that was not taxed beforehand. And so that's the situation this time around for the 2019 tax year. I had both types of income where I was getting full-time pay that was not having any money withheld for taxes. And then I also had self-employment income. And so as a result, I owe several thousand dollars in taxes. But fortunately, I don't have to pay them until July 15th. But this is great timing because I'll be getting paid soon and I'll be able to use the money that I'm getting from this job to be able to pay off my taxes before they even accrue any interest. So this is really good for me. The fifth thing that I want to do with the new income that I will be making is to beef up my emergency fund. I talked about this in previous videos where I said that I had an emergency fund of several thousand dollars, but that I would be using that money to be able to put towards costs related to building up my new business called Public Health Force. And I did that. I spent a lot of money from my emergency fund to be able to build up this new business. And as a result, I need to build up my emergency fund a whole lot. My goal is to have at minimum $15,000 in an emergency fund. So I need to take the income that I'm making and save that for that goal. And I plan on doing this in two different ways. So I have a certificate of deposit, also known as a CD. It's an account where it locks in the interest rate at whatever time that you started the account. So back in June of last year, I opened up this CD and I put in $500 into the CD. I had actually intended to put more money because I didn't realize that it was a CD. Long story. But I put $500 in and that has been locked in at I think a rate of 2.6%. So that's a really good interest rate, especially for these times when interest rates are like probably zero. But I want to be able to put more money into that CD and be able to take advantage of that high interest rate that I was able to lock in. So my plan is to add more money when the CD matures and is eligible for renewal. So that happens in June. So I have a little over $500 in it now because of the interest that has accrued throughout the year. And so I want to put I want to have in total about $5,000 in that account. So I need to contribute another $4,500 to that. And then I don't know what I'm gonna do with the rest of the money. It's an extra $10,000 at minimum that I want to have in my emergency fund. I don't know if I'm just gonna put that in a high yield interest savings account, which we know nowadays ain't really high yield at all. But I'm thinking maybe putting the rest there because it's a little bit more liquid and I'll be able to at least accrue some interest. But I haven't really decided yet on the full plan for that money. Now, the last thing that I wanna tackle is, of course, my student loans. My last and only debt. Here's the plan. I have $53,000 of student loans, which is all principal balance. I have no unpaid interest. And so the plan is to utilize this 6-month period where we aren't accruing any interest to be able to pay down some of the balances on my student loans. So within this large $53,000 student loan, I actually have six different loan accounts, like mini accounts in that one account. So of those six, two are subsidized loans and then the remaining four are unsubsidized loans. What I want to do is potentially pay off three of those student loan balances that are falling under the unsubsidized loan account. And here's the deal. Three of those accounts total to $14,319. But then I have another unsubsidized loan that is really large. It's about $22,000. I will actually take that total amount and not pay off those two or three smaller accounts, but actually put it towards the larger $22,000 loan. I know that's confusing, but this is the way that I'm rationalizing it. By September 29th, to be on the safe side, so that way all of that money goes straight to my principal balance. Most of these goals I actually need to accomplish around June or July in order to make them happen. And then some of them I have all the way until September or even the rest of the year to do. But in order to meet these objectives, I actually need to pay about, at some point, upwards to $6,600 a month, which is actually gonna be doable for me because I should still have several thousand dollars of income that I can use for my basic necessities. So this sounds like a lot, but it's actually gonna be very doable for me. But it's going to require a lot of discipline still. So although my income has gone up, I'm still having to be very diligent and putting a lot of money towards me and my financial goals. But as you can see, I'm gonna be able to knock out a whole lot of financial plans. I'm gonna be able to max out my 401k, HSA, IRA, so I got all the investing stuff on deck. And then I'm gonna be able to pay my taxes and also be able to build up my emergency fund and pay down my debt. So as you can imagine, this job is setting your girl up on a trajectory to really, really build wealth. So I'm super excited about it, and I'm so glad that you are on the journey with me, because you've been with me through it all, where I was super duper broke, but making some money, trying to make it shake, having several different jobs, teaching you all about all the jobs that I had, paying down massive amount of debt by myself, to having no income, and now having lots of income and being able to make huge strides with my personal finances. So I really appreciate you for the support throughout it all. And I hope that you will stick with me and be riding with me as I knock out these goals. And hopefully I'll be able to take you along on the ride where you'll be able to eliminate your debt, increase your income, and build wealth right along with me, because I got you, okay? We are going to do this. And I'm so thankful that I can do it with you. So I appreciate you for watching, and I hope that you are subscribed so I can see you in the next video.